Hi, I'm Rachel Moot, back here at the Animal Care Center, or ACC, and today I will be talking to you about our dwarf seahorse friend. Here at the ACC, we have been working to maintain a behind-the-scenes breeding population of dwarf seahorses to supply to the dwarf seahorse exhibit in the Yawkey Gallery. Dwarf seahorses only live approximately 1 year in the wild and up to 2 years in captivity, so in order to have a healthy population for exhibit, we decided to start our own breeding program. This is where the ACC comes in. We have a setup of 6 specialized tanks called pseudocrysals, which are ideal for seahorse holding and breeding. Pseudocrysals are U-shaped tanks with rounded edges, allowing for gentle flow, which keeps live planktonic food suspended in the water column. This is why they are ideal for seahorses, who eat brine shrimp. Here at the ACC, we feed our seahorses adult and newly hatched brine shrimp, as well as copepods. Seahorses have a very interesting way of reproducing. The male seahorse is the one who is pregnant, rather than the female. He has a specialized pouch, which is designed to hold the fertilized eggs in safety until they are fully developed, at which point the live fry are released into the world. Dwarf seahorses are also monogamous, which means they pair up for life. Since this is such an important decision, they can be a bit particular. Oftentimes we have found that our seahorses will pick partners who are the same size and color as themselves. So when we pick out a male and female to put together in our breeding tank, we try to keep these preferences in mind. In the beginning, when a new male and female have been introduced to each other, we get to observe their unique courting behavior, which is a 4-step, multi-day process. It generally starts in the morning, 1 to 2 days before a breeding event. The first 3 phases involve a variety of behaviors, including the following: brightening of their coloration by both the males and females, alternating quivering between the male and female where they vibrate and shake back and forth rapidly while sitting side by side, and alternating pointing upwards with their heads. During this time, we also observe the male overinflating his pouch with water to an exceptionally large balloon-like state. This posturing likely displays his maximum egg-holding capacity. He does this by opening his pouch slightly and rapidly pumping his body forward to force water inside. If the female shows no interest, he will deflate his pouch and expel all the water, trying again later. If these courting rituals are successful, the seahorses proceed to the final phase, during which the breeding event occurs. Both the male and female repeatedly rise together in the water column in a dance until the female essentially deposits her eggs directly in the pouch of the male. 10 to 14 days later, the male seahorse gives birth. When the time is right, the male will go through a series of muscle and body spasms and expel 10 to 30 baby seahorses into the water column. These babies, or fry, are fully formed and able to feed themselves on their own. They look just like miniature adults and are approximately 8 millimeters in size, a little larger than a grain of rice, whereas adults are 20 to 25 millimeters, or approximately 1 inch. We let the fry stay in the same tank as their parents for a couple of days, as there's no risk of predation from their adult counterparts. After they've had a couple of days to settle, we will move the fry into a separate tank for them to grow up. This way, we are able to ensure that they have the optimal habitat, food, and flow. We feed them almost the same diet as the adults, with the exception of the adult brine shrimp, which are too big for them to eat. It will take about 4 months until these fry are mature enough to start breeding on their own. When they reach adult size, we will move them into a separate holding tank. From here, they will either go to exhibit in the Yawkey Gallery, get donated to another aquarium for display, or be paired up and placed in a small tank to start breeding a new generation. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this glimpse into our breeding program. Bye!